Howdy folks, this is Checkers back again with another episode of our Fallout 4 Let's Play, this time back in Far Harbor with Nick, and we are about to check out this kind of cool hotel here. And we are at the Cliff's Edge Hotel, and we've held the position here waiting for y'all to come back and join us, and now that we're all here together, let's go see what's inside. And let's change weapons, drop into stealth, bobby pin rat away, and a military cap. I guess at this point we're taking almost anything we can carry so we can bring it back and sell it. Sweater vest and slacks. What's it worth? It is worth 17. Sure, why not? We'll grab it. We don't have a whole lot of weight to carry, but I guess we could always bounce in and out.
We get a move on.
Thanks, Nick. We will do. 23 pre-war money in the cash register. And just get a little look at the perimeter outside here quick before we go in. All right. And back into stealth. Here we go. Ghoul on the ground. Just making sure. See another one. That one's now gone. Let's help that one out too. And looks like we've got some more coming in.
Nasty cannibal.
Oh.
That's one way to get them cool and pumping.
Alright, well. Four bottle caps, 638 rounds, and here we have a tablespoon, we'll leave that. Five 10mm rounds and some wonder glue. We'll grab that. Reload. Bottle cap. You can keep your ladle. Okay, not sure what's going on with that one there. Wander through the sludgy indoor fountain pool thing. See if we missed anything back here. Did we get anybody this far back? I don't think we did. Okay. We got these, we got those. Bottle cap. Huh. Okay. Out of order elevators. Looks like they were out of order before the bombs hit. Nick. Look at you going for the bayonet charge. Okay, and good night. We have it. Another one. Okay, and four bottle caps, military grade duct tape. Reloading, and okay, well, where do we go from here? Did I miss something? I mean, undoubtedly I missed something, but wonder what exactly it was that I missed. Ooh, duffel bag. 23 pre-war money. 23 appears to be the lucky pre-war money number. Huh. Okay. And nothing over here. Aha, this way. What's over here? Back down into stealth. Anything in that cabinet? No. Got a door back. Hey, Nick, I think we got company. Close by.
Sorry, folks. Won't be chewing on us.
Okay. Let's check out this door down here. Ooh. Okay.
That's it.
And some wonder glue. Nothing in the sink. And out we go. Back up the stairs. Nick holding the position, waiting for us. Good man, Nick. Alright, pop these doors.
You're up, you're up.
Okay. Got a few more down. Cue ball, a little bit of plastic. Can't hurt. Six bottle caps, 3 308 rounds. Subway token, he can keep. Screwdriver, he can keep. And I don't see anything particular over there. Anything in this? No. And we have a room here. Telephone can't hurt to take for now. That one's already dead. Oh, pre-war money. Apparently there was a lot of money here. A ladle. 9 plasma cartridges. Those will be welcome. 5 44 rounds. Those are pretty nice too. And let's see, we've got a couple of stacks of pre-war money there. Burnt trade magazine. A novice unlock on this door. And there we go.
Nice.
Hello, don't bother getting up. 3 bottle caps. 5 38 rounds and a bobby pin. 2 stim packs. And 6 bobby pins and a rat away. More money. So I'm guessing this was not a cheap hotel. And for some reason, people like to just stash wads of cash around their rooms. Maybe it was the fashion pre-war. I didn't get out to Far Harbor much, apparently. I'm not familiar with that custom. Okay, and up the ramp we go. And into a new part. There is a ghoul on the ground. And there is one trying to get off the ground. 5 bottle caps, reload. Checking 4 containers, but none there. This? Damn. Oh, what on earth? What did that mean? There were like 5 mines. Caltrops. Ow. Okay, that's fascinating. Never seen those before. Okay, well, let's, got a bear trap. Phone, we'll grab that. Some more pre-war money. Maybe the maitre d's last bribe to get somebody a good table. 2 bottle caps, toy alien, we'll grab that. I think that has aluminum in it, if I'm not incorrect. And reload, we're down 1 round. But since someone mystically reloads our magazines for us, we'll take care of that. Okay, let's set off another. Don't appear to be able to set that one off. Or that one. Not him. Must be you.
You playing hide and seek?
Okay.
Shouldn't take long.
That's 3 ghouls down. 6 bottle caps, 5 38 rounds, stim pack, tactical pipe pistol. Oh, this one has a lot we could take, but probably we couldn't carry everything if we tried. 32 45 rounds, and here is a bottle cap and 9 10 millimeter rounds. And let's see what these ghouls over here had. Some cotton yarn he can keep. Plastic spoon we'll take. 9 bottle caps, 5 10 millimeter rounds. Table knife he can keep. And we covered that. Okay. This is something I don't usually do, but I don't know if I can.
Grab anything useful.
Sure thing.
Okay. Did that work? It did. Okay. Well, there's that then. I'm learning. I may be slow, but I eventually do try and learn. Don't bother getting up. 3 bottle caps, 8 flamer fuel, fuse you can keep. Purified water down here. We'll grab those and some pre-war money. And Nuka-Cola cherry. Nothing in the ice cooler. Okay. Oh wait, cooking oil. Nice. That's a fair amount of oil. Okay. And some booze. And a lot of empties, I imagine. Okay. Let's see. What did I miss? tent. The tent is a container. That's fascinating. Well. Trapper's note, harpoon by 7, gold watch, desk fan, can, sure, why not. Let's see the trapper's note. Under, let's see, inventory and miscellaneous. And we'll scroll down to trapper's note. And take a look at it. This place is crawling with ghouls. Seems like for every one I kill, 2 more show up between that big gear thing and the terminal. I know there's one of those vaults here, but I can't find the damn thing. I'm setting up camp here, and I'll try and push further in tomorrow. Or maybe not. Okay. So, I wanted to see if there was anything fascinating over here. A quick drop down, if we so desired. Careful there, Nick. We still qualify as outside. I'll bet anything we could fast travel from here if we so desired. Oh, some cash registers. 5 bottle caps. Don't see anything out on that ledge. Let's head upstairs. Back down into stealth. Pop that ghoul. 9 bottle caps. Legendary, huh? How legendary are you feeling without your legs? Okay. And now we can just finish them off at our leisure. 3 bottle caps, 6 10mm rounds, troubleshooter's metal right arm, reduces damage from robots by 15%, 4 bottle caps, and an 8 ball, because who doesn't want an 8 ball? Okay. And let's see, looks like we are going through the windows. Down you go. There's somebody else. Right there. Deal with him. Let's see what's over here. So a few tables. Another ghoul. 738 rounds, some wonder glue. A thing. Is this where we were before? Yeah, okay. Anything out over here? Come on, up we go. Okay, this is just exploration fun, but didn't look like I can actually make the jump. You'd need some power armor with a booster, I think. And not sure there'd be anything there when we got there. So, let's head, I guess, in here, right? Research test tube, don't necessarily need that. Let's take a quick look over here, though. Okay, nothing. And into another lobby. Okay, and some double doors. And looks like we're going back down. Hear more ghoulage. Hello. Silver fork, we'll take that. Plastic fork on this one. Silver and plastic, you know. Okay, pre-war money by 47.
Thing for antiques, huh?
Pretty much.
Now you got problems.
Okay. Hey, we leveled. Glowing one, Nick. Okay. And 8 bottle caps, 2 308 rounds, 6 10mm rounds, 2 irradiated blood, nuclear material. He can keep his mole rat teeth. And let's see what we've got here. Withered ghoul with 6 10mm rounds, stim pack, Fog Ghoul with 5 bottle caps and a silver fork. And I think there was somebody way down here as well with 8 bottle caps. He can keep his table knife for now. Let's get a quick look around here. A few doors looks like we can play with, plus a way down. Okay, and let's check this door. Unlock advanced.
Sweet.
In we go. Another door here. To the washroom, and pre-war money. Flushing their money down the toilet, apparently. Well, it has no weight, and it has a little bit of worth and can be used as cloth, so that's why we always grab it. Here is a Mr. Handy with a biometric scanner, enhanced targeting card, and 2 steel. We will grab those. Some poor souls, well, actually, probably some rather wealthy souls who didn't make it, but poor souls all the same for not having made it. Here is their, basically cultural stash of money. Glass pitcher in there, and a Gwinnett Stout bottle in there. And their Pong game, and some more pre-war money. Toothpaste, sure, why not? And that's why not. Okay. Well, let's see. We have... where is our aid? There it is. Grilled Radstag. That'll boost our carry weight for a while. And you know what? While we're at it, let's drop a rat away and clear up some of that radiation as long as we're getting healed anyway. That's where we came down. There is another door over here we can check. Let's pop that open. Put that ghoul down. 6 bottle caps. And... 544 rounds. 1, 2, 3, 4 stacks. 5, 6 stacks of pre-war money. Maybe 5. Not sure. Might have overcounted there. Let's see. Anything else down here? No, just that guy. Okay, and let's head back to a ghoul above us. Did I miss one? It sounded like there was somebody in there. But if not, he'd have to be right there. Okay. 4 bottle caps. He can keep his tablespoon. Yeah, this is where we came in from outside again. All right. Back down the stairs we go. And subway token, you can keep that. Oh, hello. 7 bottle caps and a hairbrush. Missed you. Okay, back down into stealth and down the spiral staircase in our sweeping, gorgeous, rusted armor to make a grand entrance before the patina-covered man. Some Stimpak and Radex. Radex and Army Fatigues. Don't necessarily need those. Although, let's take a look at them. I think that's what I'm wearing. Apparel. Dirty Army Fatigues. Strength 1, Agility 1. Strength 1, Agility 1. Well, you know what? Let's put some clean Army... Oh, no. That's not what I meant to do at all. We'll put some clean Army Fatigues on. Apparel. Army Fatigues. Look any different? Yeah, a little bit. Well, may as well have clean clothes. Alright, and back down the grand staircase we go. Slightly more grand than a moment ago. Some more pre-war money. Dead ghoul. Okay. 4 bottle caps and a toy alien. Just making extra sure. 5 bottle caps, 738 rounds, toy alien, bottle cap, vase, probably good for ceramic, silver plate, we'll grab those. That looks like a gold-plated flip lighter. And more silver plate, and a fancy hairbrush, and a silver locket. So there is more silver in all 3 of those. Bottle cap, 2308 rounds, he can keep his mole rat teeth. And... okay, that's a turret right there. 2 functioning turrets. Burnt fashion magazine. Magnifying glass, teacup, coffee cup. So looks like we've got two elevators. What is this section right here? So we're still outside as far as the game is concerned. We're not in a structure yet. Where's Nick? Well, if we go in the elevator, we'll probably get Nick to catch up with us. So let's see. Any difference between them?
Going down.
Basement. Now let's try this one.
Basement.
Okay. Hey, the hatch
going down.
Hey, we're not actually going down. We're going up.
Ground floor.
Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Well, so there is a difference in the elevators. Apparently, unless that one... No, that one was out of order up here. So, the other one must actually go somewhere different.
Basement.
Okay. And into here. Can't open the hatch on that one. So we're just going to have to see what happens. That seems a little different. Ah, Nick! You're concerning me with your wall phasing. Maybe that's a, you know, something particular to your model. All right, out we are. And out Nick is, and he's still in one piece and not half in the wall. Some clean towels, Nick. You want to be a real hoopy frood, you better grab some. Okay, duct tape, silver locket, and some economy wonder glue. There is some Abraxo, which probably wouldn't do us wrong, but... And a gas canister must take oil. Yeah, I know, Nick. 16.556 rounds. A chef hat, a box of bobby pins, a bench that I keep running into, and let's see, a Nushanka hat, a flip lighter, good for oil again, and a used oil can, and let's see, dog bowl, three bobby pins, plastic bowl, baseball base, three more bobby pins, and we already checked that. Anything in there? No. Okay. About these? Nope. Okay. So, we came from there. We are going to here. And... we have a vault, ladies and gentlemen. Vault 118 from the looks of it. Okay, before we pop the controls there, let's take a look around quick.
Well, well. This place just got a little more interesting.
Yeah, truly. Burnt textbook. And we appear to be, well, not entirely, but mostly sealed. Okay, the door's in the way. That's about it. That's about what I can say for it. Let's come back up and pop the doors. Vault door remote access ready. And hammer the big red button.
Vault 118, your home away from home, underground. Are you the detective we sent for?
Absolutely, yes, I'm
the
detective.
Yes, I'm the detective.
Thank goodness. Let me just open the door for you.
We learned that from Ghostbusters. If someone asks you if you're in anything, you say yes. Okay, we've got a handy, I think.
Well, it's about time the police sent someone.
Coloration is interesting.
We have many important residents, and they are very worried.
Yeah. What happened?
What happened? Who died?
It's Mr. Parker, the primary owner and financier for the hotel. This is just a disaster. They're at the crime scene again.
Sounds like trouble.
Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me, detective.
All right, Maxwell, you bet. But first, I'm going to check out and see what you've got behind the counter, see? Looking for evidence. Yeah, that's it. Evidence. Hey, it's a 118 jumpsuit. Love taking the jumpsuits. Okay, and going through your magic wands. And...
What the hell do you think you're doing? This is a crime scene.
Do you not see the glory of the thing? Wow. The
no one cares for this place. What the hell is wrong with you?
Excuse me?
Ezra, you have outdone yourself. This is your finest work. There is more emotion in his death than most have had in their entire lives.
Our friend is dead, Mr. Avita. Have you no respect?
I'm just saying that at least he had the decency to make a spectacle of it. There is nothing
Please,
worse
if
than
I may.
That's
if
what this
I could
is
just
to you.
Have your attention.
You're sick.
I'm sorry for shouting, but the detective has arrived and shall begin the investigation henceforth.
Oh, boy.
Please return to your rooms until the detective has examined the crime scene and had a chance to come speak with you.
Oh, boy. So, we've
have
stumbled...
Have a look at the crime scene for clues. When you're ready, we can discuss your findings. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have solid evidence, I would avoid accusations.
Protect and serve.
Mm-hmm. Well, so, Robo Brains. Oh boy. So we've got an insane murder with insane robots, apparently. And brain containment, examine.
Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed.
Well,
I guess someone wasn't a fan of Robo Brains. At least not this one.
No kidding. Blood?
Is this blood?
Huh. Okay, Nick, you see anything else? There's some more blood. More blood. Fence buster. With a bit of a smear. Let's take a look at this. Ignores 30% of the target's damage and energy resistance. That's kind of nice. Let's grab that.
A baseball
for
bat.
Evidence.
What is this doing here?
Discuss the findings with Maxwell. Paint can.
Red paint?
Oh, now it's stealing if I want to take a look at it again, huh?
This isn't blood. It's red paint.
Okay, so... This is an artistic statement, basically. Anything else in the room? It said we should talk to Maxwell, but let's check out everything else here. Got a Protectron Watcher. Another Protectron Watcher. So we've got robots watching robots, but we've got, well, at least two robots left that have some wetware issues in having human brains. So let's talk with Maxwell here.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
It's red paint, not
That's
blood.
That's not blood around the body. It's red paint.
Mr. Santiago would definitely have red paint, but surely he wouldn't have... Would he? This is just terrible, Detective. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
I found the murder weapon.
Oh, no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing. Was there anything else?
So the residents are robots?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis. Was there anything else?
Okay, about the
Tell
victim.
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel. He had vast experience managing venture projects around the world. It was his idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
Where to start?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, then I suppose you'll need to confront the killer. Was there anything else?
No thanks, Maxwell.
I'll be here should you need me.
Alrighty, well, we have a lovely murder mystery of RoboBrains. And I haven't seen this, of course, yet, so I don't know who done it, but I'm sure we'll figure it out. Although, you know what? For swinging baseball bats, that handy arm might come in kind of handy. Alright, other than that, let's say that this has been Checkers with another episode of our Fallout 4 Let's Play, and we will be back next time and continue our murder investigation with Nick Valentine.
What do you think actually won the war? Nobody, I guess.
Alrighty. This has been Checkers. I would like to remind you that I have a Twitter link in the description of the video and on my channel main page. If you're on mobile, it'll be on my channel about page. Also, if you look in the upper right-hand corner, you will see a small letter I with a white circle around it. These are cards and links to other videos that I've made. I would like to thank you for watching. I hope you found the video entertaining and maybe just a little informative. I would like to invite you to subscribe, like, and share if you so desire, and ask you to please take care.